गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ बेसिक इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स मॉड्यूल नंबर 4. आई हैव स्टार्टेड मॉड्यूल नंबर 4 इन द यस्टरडेज वीडियो लेक्चर. ओके, सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट व्हाट इज ऑसिलेटर. ओके, व्हाट इज द फंक्शनिंग ऑफ ऑसिलेटर, व्हाट इज बेसिकली द ऑपरेशन ऑफ ऑसिलेटर. ओके, एंड दिस ऑसिलेटर इज बेसिकली इट्स एन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइस विच जनरेट्स द ऑसिलेशंस ऑफ इट कैन बी इन टर्म्स ऑफ साइन वेव और इट कैन बी स्क्वायर वेव और ट्रायंगुलर वेव. ओके, एनी वेव फॉर्म विच यू वॉन्ट दैट ऑसिलेटर विल बी डिजाइन बेस्ड ऑन द टाइप ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल सर्किट वॉट वी डू. ओके, एंड टूडे वी विल सी सम ऑर द अदर डेफिनेशंस ऑफ ऑसिलेटर एंड एज वेल एज टूडे वी विल गो एंड सी हाउ टू डिजाइन ए ऑसिलेटर. ओके, सो इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी विल फॉलो दिस कंप्लीट सीरीज ऑफ oscillators. Now, before going to the design of oscillator here, you need to know about the criteria which is required for the oscillator. Okay, for example, if you want to design any, take an example of your mechanical section. Okay, if you want to design an engine, okay, you need to study the basic parts of the engine which is required and how it will help you to make it more efficient. Similarly, you take any of the electrical circuit, any of the mechanical, any of the departments example, right? You require some criteria, some principles, some characteristics. Okay, so based on those characteristics or design, we try to go for designing of the application part. Now here we will speak of the oscillator. Okay, so basically oscillator is a electronic circuit. Okay, which makes use of your RC components or your LC components. Based on those components, okay, we will design the oscillator. And other than that, here there is some criteria the oscillator should follow. Okay, and the name of that criteria is known as Barkhausen's criteria. Okay, what is this Barkhausen's criteria? How this value is made equal to 1. Okay, in the previous video lecture, if you carefully listen to that previous video lecture, we have seen, we have derived the equation for the output voltage of the oscillator, or simply you can define as the output signal which we get after the whatever the oscillations are produced. Okay, and not only the oscillations, but we have also calculated the factor called as a beta factor and gain. So we have taken one amplifier, we have applied the input signal, we have processed that, then a feedback is taken from output and then applied back to the input section. Okay, then how the calculation we have done, we have seen in the previous video lecture. Now today we will speak out the what is the Barkhausen criteria, what is the design criteria required for oscillator. Here in this design criteria, the magnitude of the loop gain must be unity or slightly larger. Okay, so yesterday's in class we have seen that the magnitude or the closed loop gain of the oscillator is defined in terms of the A and in terms of nothing but beta. Okay, where beta is called as a feedback factor. Okay, so therefore this magnitude of the loop, so whatever the output you get after the at the oscillator, okay, and when you measure its magnitude across the closed loop gain, here it should be closed loop, it should not be an open loop gain. Okay, so therefore it should be a closed loop gain, and when you measure the magnitude of that particular closed loop, okay, and gain, that is output divided by input, okay, it should be equal to 1 or sometimes slighter than or a bit larger than 1. Therefore the Barkhausen criteria is given by mod of A into beta is equal to 1. Okay, so we define this by the name called as Barkhausen criteria. Similarly, there is the another criteria for oscillator which is known as, which is here as the total phase shift, okay, of the closed loop gain, which is denoted by the symbol phi. Okay, it must be either 0 degree or it should be 360 degree. This is my second criteria. Whenever you go for the design of oscillator, it should make sure that the phase or the total phase when you measure across the oscillator, either it should be 0 degree or it should be 360 degree. So the two criteria are the alpha beta, sorry, A beta should be equal to 1
and the phase obtained across the closed loop should be either 0 degree or 360 degree. Now, what are the various type of oscillators we have? Based on the type of the material, components which we have, they are RC oscillators. We sometimes call it as an RC phase shift oscillator. Okay, where this RC oscillator or the RC feedback, you can say across the feedback we have the RC sections. We will see one by one how this RC oscillator will work out. Okay, so RC feedback oscillators are generally they are limited to some frequency, and it is 1 megahertz or sometimes less than 1 megahertz. The frequency of oscillations of this particular RC feedback, it should not go beyond 1 megahertz. Okay, so this is the another criteria that we can say. Okay, and based on the type of this feedback, the RC oscillators are discussed into two types, that is Wien's bridge oscillator and phase shift oscillator, or simply it can be called Wien's bridge oscillator and RC phase shift oscillator. Now let us look into the first type of oscillator here, which is a Wien's bridge oscillator. This Wien's bridge oscillator, okay, is designed in such a way that it makes use of two RC sections. Here you can see, okay, this is RC one section and this is RS, which is another section. And here this R and this RC and this RC, they are parallel to each other, or by simply you can make the connection as the voltage divider type. So the first RC section here, we denote this impedance of this particular RC as ZS and this RC as ZP. Okay, and the output is measured across the output terminal of this particular op amp. Even you can make use of op amp to generate the oscillations. Okay, the triangular wave, the triangular shape here, you can see it's an op amp. Okay, so basically the input to this op amp is applied at the positive terminal of op amp. We call it as the non-inverting terminal of op amp. Okay, so whenever I apply the input voltage at this VI or V1, then it will produces the oscillation, making sure that it should satisfy the design criteria that A beta is equal to 1, or it either produces the 0 degree or 360 degree. But the Wien's bridge oscillator produces 0 degree phase shift. Now let us go for the working principle of the Wien's bridge oscillator. Basically, the feedback signal in the oscillator circuit is connected to non-inverting input terminal of op amp, okay, which I have shown here in the figure, which is at this particular point, that is plus. Then the second thing here is the condition of non-zero phase shift around the circuit is achieved by the balancing the bridge. Also, balancing the bridge, zero phase shift is essential for sustained oscillation. That is what I have said, either it should be zero or it should be 360 degrees. So therefore, it is balanced in such a way that it produces 0 degree phase shift. So one phase shift will be applied across, one phase shift is obtained across the input side of the op amp, and the another is obtained at the in the feedback loop or feedback mechanism of this particular circuit, where those two phase shift will cancel out each other and they will give you 0 degree phase shift. The frequency of oscillation for the Wien's bridge can be obtained by this expression, that is F naught, frequency of oscillation is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi RC, where F naught can also be taken as a resonant frequency, or at resonant frequency F naught, the inverting terminal and the non-inverting input will be equal and they are in phase, so that the negative signal will be cancelled out by positive feedback causing the circuit to oscillate. That is what one phase is obtained at the positive terminal and the another phase is obtained at the negative terminal of the op amp, and when they both together they get cancelled out, each other cancelled out, such that the circuit will oscillate. Then the third point says that from the complete analysis of this particular figure here, it says that the feedback factor beta is equal to 1 divided by 3 at the frequency of oscillation. Therefore, if you want to obtain the sustained oscillation for this Wendt bridge oscillator, the amplifier must have a gain of 3 so that the loop gains becomes unity, and this unity will take us to Barkhausen's criteria. So the first criteria of Barkhausen is satisfied, therefore the Wendt bridge oscillator will sustain or it will produce the oscillation. So in this way the Wendt bridge is produces the frequency oscillations of that particular frequency. Now the formula here to calculate the loop gain for this Wendt bridge oscillator is given by As into beta S, or simply you can write it as A into beta, okay, which is equal to 1 plus R2 by R1. Okay, so here from this you can see this is, if you take this is R1 and this is R2, okay, at the feedback side, and this is ZS and this is ZP. Okay, so 1 plus R2 by R1, why, if you look at this particular formula, this formula is for non-inverting amplifier or non-inverting op-amp, because the non-inverting op-amp has a gain of 1 plus RF by R1, or you can take it as R2 by R1. Okay, and the factor beta is taken as ZP divided by Z plus ZS, where this ZP is equal to 1 plus S into RC, and ZS is equal to 1 plus SRC divided by SC. From that particular figure, we represent the their impedance in terms of ZP and ZS. Now, if you substitute the these values here in that formula, okay, for this ZP and ZS in this particular formula, okay, we get the total answer as 1 plus R2 by R1 multiplied by 1 divided by 3 plus SRC plus 1 divided by S into RC. Okay, now if I substitute this value of S is equal to j omega, okay, put S is equal to j omega, so what we get, 1 plus R2 by R1 will be as it is, instead of S we write it as j omega, okay, and here 3 will be as it is, S is equal to j omega RC plus 1 divided by j omega into R into C. Okay, now to find the frequency of oscillation at the particular frequency F0, right, we want the frequency of oscillation, that is one, what answer we got for the frequency of oscillation is 1 divided by 2 pi into RC, right? So here what we can write here is, instead of the omega we can write it as omega naught, okay, because omega is equal to 2 pi F, right, omega is equal to 2 pi F, so therefore just replacing this omega letter by omega naught. So the equation what we obtain is 1 plus R2 by R1 multiplied by 1 divided by 3 plus j omega naught R into C plus 1 divided by j omega naught into R into C. Further, since the frequency of oscillation, it must be a zero, right, for the Wendt bridge oscillator, we get it zero because the inverting and non-inverting of both the op-amp, they get cancel out each other, so therefore the frequency of oscillation is equal to zero. So therefore j omega naught into RC plus 1 divided by j omega naught into RC is equal to zero. Okay, they just cancel out each other. Now therefore what is left here is this RC, okay, j omega and j will get cancelled out, and what is left is omega is equal to 1 divided by RC. This gives us the omega naught is equal to 1 by RC, right? So what is actually the omega here is nothing but omega is equal to 2 pi F, right? So 2 pi, you can take it as a 2 pi F naught also, okay? So if you take here as a 2 pi, okay, 2 pi F naught it is, okay, 2 pi F naught. Okay, so this 2 pi will come into the denominator of this 1 by RC. So it becomes F naught is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi into RC. So with this, we obtain the frequency of oscillations. Okay, now from the previous equation, if you look at this particular equation here, what I have written for the frequency of oscillation. Okay, so if I consider this particular equation and if I try to, if I take the condition for the magnitude, right? So what the magnitude condition says that the frequency of oscillation is will oscillate, or the Wendt bridge will oscillate at 1 divided by 3. Okay, so therefore I will be considering this 1 by 3 for the magnitude. So therefore, what is Tj omega is equal to 1 is equal to 1 plus R2 divided by R1 will be as it is. And here I will take only 1 by 3. Or simply you can take it as, okay, that is R2 divided by R1, which is equal to 2. How this is 2? This 3 will go on the other side. So that is 3 minus 1 is equal to 2. Okay. So in this way, you can go for finding the values of oscillations. Now, to make sure that the oscillation which is at this particular ratio, that is R2 divided by R1, must be greater than 2. Okay. So whenever you find these R2 and R1, okay, and want to have for the calculation, make sure that this R2 divided by R1, it should be greater than at least this particular value 2. Okay. So in this way, we try to go for finding the resistance value for the given circuit diagram. So therefore, what is the ratio? R2 by R1 is equal to 2. Okay. Then what should be the value of K now? K is equal to 1 plus R2 by R3 is equal to 3. Okay. So therefore, K is equal to this particular 3. What is R2 by R1? It is 2. Right. So 1 plus 2 is equal to how much? It is 3. Okay. So therefore, if K is equal to 3, ensures that the loop gain of unit, the loop gain of unity of oscillation. Okay, and if K is greater than 3, then you get growing oscillations, but big oscillations, bigger oscillations you will get, increasing in magnitude. Okay, and if the value of K is less than 3, then you will get the decrease in the oscillations. So in this way, we try to go for finding the different oscillations at different variables. Okay, so this is the circuit diagram for the Weinbridge oscillator. Okay, and they have asked the question here. Okay, so the question here is, you need to, for the required oscillation of one f0 is equal to 1 kilohertz, okay, so you need to get the oscillations at the output of the circuit diagram for this particular frequency, that is f0 is equal to 1 kilohertz. Okay, so for that they have given the value of capacitor as 0.01 microfarad. Okay, then R1 is equal to 1.6 kilovolts or you can take it as 1.5, which is a standard value. Okay, and the gain of the amplifier section is given by Ri is equal to 1 kilo ohm. Ri, you can say that is input resistance is 1 kilo ohm, and the feedback resistance is a variable feedback, which is given by 0.7 kilo ohm, and this feedback will be your potentiometer. Okay, so if you find those particular, if you substitute all these values in this particular circuit diagram, okay, then you will get the frequency of oscillation of, and when you measure those frequency of oscillation, you will get approximately 1 kilohertz sine wave. Okay, so therefore, the phase shift oscillator, okay, for particular phase shift oscillator, here you require at least one capacitor, one resistance, and another capacitor and resistance. Simply, you can say that two RC sections you may require for the design of your Weinbridge oscillator, and that too it should be in, connected in such a way fashion that one should be connected at the positive terminal of the op amp and another should be connected at the negative terminal of the op amp. Okay, so in this way we go for finding the value of oscillation for a given number of resistance, given for a given value of resistance and capacitor. So with this lecture, I conclude the working principle of the Weinbridge oscillator. In the next video lecture, we will look into the RC phase shift oscillator. It is another type of oscillator. What is the total phase shift obtained for that particular RC phase shift oscillator? Either it is 0 degree or whether it is 360 degree. Okay. So if we conclude that the Weinbridge oscillator produces 0 degree phase shift. Always remember, Weinbridge is equal to 0, RC is equal to 360 degree. Okay. So you need to show that the Weinbridge is producing 0 degree phase shift at the output side of the circuit diagram. With this, I conclude today's lecture. Thank you.